Hello everyone. I've traveled a lot, trying to get international exposure as much as possible, and I thought that I'm culturally diverse. Until I came to Asia. It took me 1 week to get over jet lag. It took me 2 weeks to get used to Korean food. After eight weeks, I got over the fact that I was the main attraction of the subway. Being the minority in Asia was difficult, but at the same time, a profound experience. The experience that made me understand who I really am and where I come from. The experience that I had on personal level is now useful on professional as well. So in the next few minutes, I will try to explore how the different aspects of Asian and Western culture can influence the outcome of business meetings. Let me tell you a story. Actually, I'm going to tell the story twice. Let's meet Mr. Kim. He came to Thomas, a CEO of a Polish company. A secretary opened her calendar and found Mr. Kim's names written in red. It was urgent. Thomas invited Mr. Kim to the office. They quickly exchanged business cards, and Thomas got to the point. Thomas tried to show sincerity and genuine interest by making firm eye contact, just like his dad taught him. They went for a drink, and Thomas pushed harder to close the deal. Now, what do you think was the outcome of that story? We can say from perspective of Western culture, it was rather a standard day. Now, let me repeat the story again, but this time through Asian lenses. Do you remember Secretary's calendar? Here we have the first problem. How Mr. Kim was surprised to find out that he was dead. Oh yes, dead. In Korea, if you write someone's name in red, it means he's already dead or you want him dead. Furthermore, when Thomas received a business card from Mr. Kim, he simply placed it in his desk, which might become a serious offense for Mr. Kim. Status and position are important everywhere, especially in Korea. So take the time to thoroughly read offered business card. And by the way, please use both hands when you receive it. And remember, business is all about making relations. So do not apply the Western time is money, unless you want to fail. Koreans, as majority of Southeast Asians, tend to engage in a small extensive talk before getting to business. So be prepared for 20 minutes of my son graduated from Harvard. So do you remember when Ms. Thomas tried to make a good impression by a firm eye contact? The reality is it made Mr. Kim uncomfortable. In Korea, a too long gaze is a sign of aggressive behavior. Now let's back to the bar with our businessman. Since in Korea, closing a deal is a complex process, which requires a company to produce numerous reports, and then reports about reports, and then reports about reports about reports. Thomas most likely lost the deal at this point by pushing Mr. Kim too hard to close the deal at the same day. So if you are conducting a business with Asians, especially with Koreans, consult a person who knows local customs, who lived there. If you cannot afford such a person, at least do your homework, a simple task that is often overlooked. And the result of that oversight might be a bitter aftertaste for you and a financial loss to your company. Thank you very much.